Hello, anyone and everyone. I am Echo, and today we are exploring Obduction, the game from the people you know, Cyan Worlds, point-and-click adventure game, all that, blah blah blah. Yeah. Sorry, I'm rambling a little bit because I forgot what I wanted to say. We're over here by the side. We just took down a note for some weirdly shaped rocks that are presumably going to be the answer to a puzzle at some point. We've got a locked door. Another locked door, and I think a fourth locked door. We're racking up quite a lot of locked doors currently, and we've got a big mysterious-ass tower. We got a little bit of building here that doesn't really seem to be doing much. Can we actually? Oh, wait a minute. I should check if we can pick this up and examine it or anything. Nope, we cannot. Okay. And we got this generator over here that we seem to have turned the power on. Yep, it seems to be running. Seems to be. The primer stuff is still in there. It's still got the fuel. That switch is still on. The light is still yellow. I see no reason to believe it's off, except it's not making noise for some reason. It only made noise when we turned it on, and then it stopped making noise almost immediately. So, I'm gonna hope that it's not some type of time-sensitive thing. Okay, I was thinking maybe we could squeeze through the hole. Wouldn't make much sense, I guess, but, you know. Whatever. Okay, so actually, before we go through the forest of dead frame rates, let's go back to the map real quick, because I want to take a quick look around. Alright, I know we're at right here, actually. We're in the very middle. The sphere is that thing right there. That's the tower. I guess the red line was probably connecting to that generator. I guess that's what it must be. Garage would obviously be right back there. That's obviously a garage. And then ramp. I think ramp is this right back here. This must be, right? In terms of the placement on the map and the placement of that, it seems to all connect correctly. Then there's tunnel and scrap. Tunnel would be on the other side of the river, somewhere over there, probably in the rocks. We can't actually see it. It's not like a visible area from here. We probably need to get that water pushy door thing to turn in the other direction before we can get over there. And scrap is probably up over those rocks and like over to the left. That's probably the scrap area. So that thing doesn't seem to be on this map, because that would be about right here or so. I mean, even if we can't figure out the spot on the map it would be, it's obviously in between Farley and the garage, because we know the garage is right there. We know Farley's house is like over there somewhere, so it would have to be in between those two on the map. But there's nothing on the map in between Garage and Farley. So I don't know what that thing's called. I don't know what its purpose is. I don't know how to get there. Great, we're off to a fantastic start. Okay. I'm now 5 episodes in, and oh hey, I just noticed there's a button here. Okay, that still doesn't do anything. Alright. I didn't think it would, because the generator we turned on was not connected to this. That is connected to... God damn it, frame rate, please. Making it really hard to just... Yeah, that's still connected to that. So is that not giving power? If this isn't working? I'm not sure. I am not sure. Okay, though. Anyway. Let's head back here. And let's go talk to CW. Or whatever his name is. Oh, whoops, wrong way. Right, that's a different path that we'll have to do another day. Yeah, we're gonna go talk to CW because regardless of what I managed to do with that generator, he should be aware that it's back on. Because he seems to, whatever place he's in, He seems to be aware of how much power is available since he talked about it. Oh no, that pop in on those pipes was bad. So, yeah, we're just gonna go. Oh, did I pass him? I passed him. He's over here. Whoops. I forgot. He's not quite in the main town. Alright. So, what have you got to say, buddy? Okay, so we still have to get the Carfin power turned back on. Carfin being a funny swear word here, obviously. So, goddamn it! All right, is this button gonna work? No. All right, cool. Oh, music! What are you doing to me? What are you doing, music? Are you telling me I messed up? Or that I'm close to figuring something out? I don't know. Like, I legit don't know. Alright. We can't even get up there anymore, because the... Yeah, how are we supposed to get back up there if we can't get the thing working? Because the... The whatchamacallit, the bridge, we can't turn it in the other, the bridge, the waterfall. When we put that gate up to let the water through there, we can't put the gate back down, so how are we ever going to get back up there again? Probably something to do with the, with that over there, I would imagine. Huh. Okay, so, he doesn't have time for hand-holding. And we need to get the power back on, which is what I thought we just did. So, I guess now's the part where I wander around aimlessly and hope to find something that, works. This is in roughly the right area where, that generator was. Like, I think it would be on the other side of here or something. And of course, this door, this immaculately textured door, is still locked, so can't do much with that. But maybe that generator powered this thing. Oh wait, no, that's just a hand crank. Never mind. Yeah, no, that's just a hand crank system. We're just gonna have to get down there and pull that. Oh. What's all this now, then? I don't see much. On the other side of here, though, is rocks. So, if we do get to the other side of this and look through that hole, I'll have to remember these rocks to know where we are. Alright. Let's go back this way, then. Let's try and see what else there is to see. I hope this isn't the only area in the game. I mean, obviously there's plenty to figure out that I haven't figured out yet, but it still seems kind of small. So I am hoping that we'll eventually somehow like teleport to another area. Music, don't tease me, please. I'm trying my best here. I don't know if the music is just, like, randomly coming on. Or, oh, hey! Here you go. Alright, there's nothing written on it. But there is one kind of inconspicuous thing here. And that's these weird... this weird crap on the side here. It might be nothing, but... I mean, the game let us interact with it. So, I'm gonna... for now, I'll assume it might be important. And this looks like a puzzle answer of some kind. So, three circles on top. One big domey part on the bottom. Or, I mean, in the middle. And then, like, a little sort of switch-looking thing next to it. And, two more switch-looking things below them. Alright. So, I'll keep that in mind just in case. Also, can we ring the bell? Nope. Okay. Also, this is a fire truck, so maybe the fact that it's a fire truck is a little bit of a clue. Like, maybe whatever this is has to do with a fire truck, or maybe that gas can that was by the gas station or something. Not sure. Oh, man, but it is really annoying that, yeah, that's still unlocked. I mean, still locked, not unlocked. Yeah, it's really annoying that I don't know what that generator did that we turned on. The one that was, like, shaped like a train. Oh my god, please, frame rate. It seems the frame rate does get worse when we try sprinting. Which wouldn't be a huge deal if our base running speed wasn't so low. And the area is, it's not massive, it's not really big, but it's well stretched out. You have to walk for a hot minute before you get to, you know, the various places where important stuff is happening, basically. Alright, let's look at this again. Just in case there's something we can interact with that I missed. I missed that fire truck, of course, so it's entirely possible. For now, though, I think... I mean, I'm looking around trying to remember. We still can't get up anywhere. We can't get up to those walkways or anything. We couldn't manipulate the laser if we could even get back up there. We've got rocks all over the place, blocking off entrances. That door was locked. It was, wasn't it? Yeah, that door was locked. So that wouldn't help us much. Is this... wait a minute, is this side... okay, yeah, that's blocked by that wall there. Okay. I was wondering if we turned it back, would we be able to walk along the left bank over there? But no, we would not. Alright, anything here? I'm working my way back towards that generator thing. Because I'm going to try messing with that some more. I'm thinking... oh! Yep, I knew it. I knew I missed something. These have... it's got scorch marks on it? That hardly seems important. Nope, not gonna do anything. Can't take the top off of this. I guess, guess I'm thinking, maybe overthinking how interactive these things should be? I guess. Because so far, even the lamp, which I saw was supposed to be an interactive object in that preview thingy, Even the lamp has not been, we couldn't do anything with it. We couldn't do anything with the fire truck. Or that, jar there. That, like, tin jar. So, I don't know. Okay. Anything along the left side here? I don't think I actually came over and explored this little nook and cranny. No, it's all blocked off. What's even the door to get in this area? I guess the, oh, hold up. These aren't buttons, are they? No. Okay, good. I was just thinking if maybe that generator actually powered this or something, and this then distributed the power to everything else. That would be crazy. But no, that does not seem to be the case. So I guess the only way to actually get in here would be through this door. If we could get this somehow to lift up. But there isn't even a switch out here. That's annoying. Okay, there's a, this is the gas canister I mentioned that I thought maybe the fire truck was a bit of a clue for. We can't even get any closer to it, so I doubt we're supposed to do anything with that. And looking from this side, I don't see anything interesting. Yeah, that's kind of crazy though. There isn't even like a button or a switch that seems to. Hey. Okay, cool. We can interact with this. All right, so we're gonna need to find a phone number or some words. What if we dial operator? Well, it's also missing the actual phone. Okay. So we need to find a phone number for that. Let me make a note of that real quick. So, need to find phone number. Number four, payphone. Outside gas station. Okay. And also there was that door that needed a code. Door needs code. I don't remember where that was at the moment. I'm sure we'll see it again though. I think that was up like left over there past all that stuff. So, alright, I'll need to keep an eye out for a phone number somewhere. Maybe? This might be kind of crazy, but maybe we could actually look in here and see a phone number? Oh, holy crap, we can see license plate numbers. Those aren't the same thing, but, maybe. There's a whole bunch of them, though. Huh. And they're not in any kind of pattern. Go to this door. This window. This isn't a door. You make a better window than a door, kid. No. Because I'm thinking maybe if the gas station had a phone number posted up, and it's like supposed to be the phone number of the gas station, then maybe that's the trick. Maybe if we're, you know, if we put in the phone number over at that payphone, it would make the gas station door open. Not sure. Alright. Now, I think we've looked around enough. Let's run back up to the generator here. And it's clearly, it's only connected, Like, the fuel is connected to the gas station. We already pumped fuel through, so we don't really need to mess with that anymore. And then this big, thick bundle of wires just goes back to the map, which is at the ramp area. And, what else is here? What else is this generator connected to? To try and figure out what it's for, we should be able to see what it's connected to, right? And, oh! There's a number on it. 2501. Okay, that's not a phone number, but it's something. And what's that say? Barry? Not sure what that says. It's frickin' graffiti. Can't read that. 9H9PD? Again. Weird. Not sure exactly what that says. Hope the game doesn't expect me to understand graffiti writing. Alright, let's, alright, I'm gonna try something. In case this is time-sensitive, maybe. Maybe this is, maybe this generator only sort of pumps out electricity for a little bit. Or something. I don't know. So, we're gonna try. Oh, wait a minute. Am I an idiot? Holy crap. So, I turned it to the right, held it for like a second, and then let go. It didn't turn on fully. So what you need to do is you need to actually hold down the frickin' start key to get it to turn on fully. Now the power's on. Now it's actually gonna... Okay. Three things I'm gonna check right away. God, I'm such an idiot, too. That's such an obvious thing. Like, I've never worked with engines or anything like that in real life. So maybe that's how they work in real life, and maybe if I had known that, I would have thought to try it, but I don't know. So, okay, this is still locked. Let's check out the map. And, I mean, we've got the power back on. Maybe not all of it, but definitely more than there was before, and it is actually legitimately on. Yep, the map is all lit up. So, Sphere, Tower, Farley, CW... Tunnel and Scrap are all lit up. Garage, Ramp, and Town are not. But that's fine. So I'm assuming this means each of those areas now has electricity to make whatever machines were around them work better. So, in that case, I don't know what the sphere would need power for. Well, this button, obviously. And it's even lit up green. Okay, we're not going to touch it yet, though, because I don't know what it'll do, and I don't want to accidentally mess it up. Because if we need to do that thing... Oh, wait a minute. Is this a... Oh, no, that's right. We need to get to the other side to push that ramp down. So yeah, because if we need to do anything with that sphere in a specific order, I don't want to accidentally jump the gun and press the button and have it, mess up in advance. Oh geez, frame rate, please stop! Frame rate! Oh my god. This is the most painful. The most painful. Alright, we need to go to the right. Turning on the electricity just made the game run worse. Holy shit. I hope you're all, like, seeing this. It's not just me. Oy vey. Okay, let's talk to UCW because we got the power back on for reals now. So you better be happy.
No power's on. Did you come back for a medal? Sorry, I don't mean to neglect my manners. My name is Cecil. Most around here call me CW. I suppose you gotta move on, but, alright, well, if you ain't
Okay, not a lot to go on, but I think it's pretty clear what we need to do next. That red beam, you do something with it. But what? We can't even get back up there. Dude. Because this still isn't working. Yeah. Music in this game is awesome, I told you. I knew it. Before it even started, I knew it was going to be awesome. Let's just see if he has anything else to say. I know he probably doesn't. He'll probably just say, oh, no handholding or whatever, but whatever.
We ain't making further progress till you disable that red mofang beam. You're going to have to get through the wall of this cell.
Okay. So, ultimately, our goal is to disable the beam. Unfortunately, that... Maybe I wasn't paying attention. It didn't seem to be very clear if we were supposed to be disabling it or changing it or whatever, but yeah. Power's on! There you go. Alright, now we can get in. So now we can get up to it, even with the elevator not working. Perfect. Perfect. Alright. Let's take a look around. That blue beam. That's a completely different device. That blue beam. Huh. Interesting. And the red one... Because the red one is designed kind of like those holographic projectors that we, get the story bits from. And that looks like a... Kind of looks like a head of some robot or something. Okay, these... What the hell are these things? I have no idea. Oh, well. Alright, and... What is this thing? Okay, a rock. Okay, that's nice. Oh! Okay, let me get to the other side. I think I should be over closer to it before I listen to this. And there are notes here, too. So let me read this real quick. CW, please change Farley's lock code to secure the vault. Her address backwards should suffice. Regards, something's... I can't read his handwriting for his own name. Oh, Mayor Jarson, or Jansen. Mayor Jansen? Okay, so when we first came into the town, the recordings, the first recording we saw was the mayor, and he said his name was Yosef. But this must be a different person? Or maybe he sometimes goes by a different name? Oh, wait a minute. No, I'm an idiot. I'm sorry. Yosef would be his first name. So his last name is Jansen. Okay. So, anyway. I'm going to have to take a note of this. Please change Farley's lock code to secure the vault. Her address backwards should suffice. So, Farley's lock code to secure the vault. I'm going to guess the vault... Because there's only one place that I've seen a code... for unlocking any door, and that was that other door that was over, like, past the sphere and everything like that. So, if he changed her thing, then that means the code would be her address backwards. So, code is Farley's address backwards. Alright, cool. Got that. And, put that down. Let's read this next one. Lockdown list. Lock Tree Gate, lock Farley's house, lock lower tower, lock upper tower. Lift minecart into workroom, turn on Mofang disabler, shut garage door, pump water from tree roots, turn on imager rocks, close swing bridge, divert river, turn off power, activate the dome disabler. Okay, that's a lot of stuff, and you know what? I'm actually going to take a little picture of it. There you go. I might use that later, might not. Who knows? We'll see. Because that's a lot of stuff to write down, and it might not actually be important. This basically just kind of lists everything that was locked up. Which, obviously, we already know they're locked up because we can't get through them. So, but it might be important, so keep an eye on it. Mofang Disabler, Villain Technology, Notes from Aprar. Aprar. Okay, that's another person, obviously. 1. Designed to disable anything based on Mofang technology. 2. Disables when blue beam / cloud is within about 1.5 feet of any Mofang device element. 3. Elements physically elements physically collapse. Reassembly is possible, but non-trivial. 4. Aprar assures me that it's not harmful, still not pointing it at my head. 5. Buko has not been told that the villains provided it. Okay. So, disables when blue beam / cloud is within about 1.5 feet of any Mofang element. So, I believe, if I remember CW correctly, he said that the red laser is a Mofang laser, a Mofang technology. I'm presuming Mofang is their name for the aliens. And the blue beam is a Mofang disabler. So if we get the blue beam pointed at the red beam or the red device, would that disable it? I'm guessing. Alright, now let's press this button.
This is a button.
Why are you so nervous? This is just bad.
Okay, now what? Okay, that's enough.
Well, I swear, you are a natural.
Where did you get these anyway? Are the Muslims just giving you something?
Yeah, it's a not gonna look a good toss in the mouth.
Huh. So it seems that they were given these. I presume by given, I mean these devices just sort of appeared out of nowhere. And these are what they recorded their little messages on to invite all the other people to the town. This was their test one. Okay. Now this. Can we turn this? Yes, we can. Oh, we're gonna aim it right at that thing. Hell yeah. Alright. Anything else we can aim it at? Doesn't seem to be much, except... we can actually probably disable this thing. You know what? This is a good mode to use the unlock cursor thingy in. Yep, there you go. Super disabled. Let's turn that off. We don't need it on. Okay, so we didn't need to destroy that, but it was fun. Because it's fun to wreck things once in a while. So, okay, now we've got a lot more options. We can go over there. Probably going to be able to get up above the tree, do stuff over there. There's plenty to do over there. And so we definitely do. I was right in figuring that out, I guess, is that we basically need to turn this blue laser to get it pointed at the red device, to turn off the red beam. So, yeah, how we're gonna do that, though, I'm not sure. I'm guessing we have to get this lowered down, though, at some point, because that must be what all the tracks down below are. Right below here is the start of those, like, minecart-looking tracks. So I'm guessing we just gotta lower this down at some point. Somehow. Alright. So, yeah, when we come back, we're gonna take a look at this thing. Have no idea what it is, but it looks cool. Then we gotta go travel down there and see what's available. And then I actually would like to also take a look around and see what other areas have been unlocked now that we've gotten the power on from that generator. So, yeah, we got a lot to do. So I will see you all next time. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I hope you continue to enjoy it. Bye-bye.